I'm Ori, and I'm Maya. This is a thief. He's very interested in things. And we're Israeli designers, basically. We're here to do social food design project. Yeah, we're looking at social street food, actually, project.
Both of us teach in Israel design. Ori has his own studio, and he's specialized in recycled wood and furniture design. My studio is a combination between industrial design and more conceptual design. I came to see what we can do with the prints and quote, and to see if there are some problems or I can stay here as long as we need. We found many similarities, I think, between the rhythm of Taiwan and Israel. And from that similarities, we felt kind of natural here, I think. And we find that the place is very rich in terms of a lot of street experiences, and it's very eclectic, and we really like that in Taiwan, and especially in Taipei. And I think there's a sense of authenticity here that we also felt quite impressed by, because there are a few little places now that you come across which they have this kind of authenticity to them because of globalization and so on. And here in many places, especially in the night markets, you can still sense that kind of authentic atmosphere that's still kept as it is, and how much the food culture here is like crazy, you know, it's everywhere, and it's so rich and full and endless. So, again, it was something that matched our personal interests. We didn't know what to expect. We heard about the night markets here, but it was much more bigger, wider, and variant than anything we imagined before.
You get that global feel of things that you know, this as if recycled timber with a bit of wash on the walls, and there's a lot of rust which is actually done on purpose, and you look at it and it kind of feels like if you take the wrong turn you'll be in another country, in another renewed place. And I think the night markets have so many qualities to offer, and I think one of the things the project attempts to do is show that things can change without losing that chaotic, slightly dirty, unsterile quality, which is, we feel, very much the beauty of what is there.
Yeah. And we also, I think this is what led us to choose the metal stool. Metal stool, we saw it as something very common in the markets, and we wanted an iconic element that is part, a very essential part of the DNA of the market, and to take it and to play a little bit within its system, so you don't create something completely new, but you use something that is already there, but you just manipulate it a little bit to create new eating configurations. I think we look at the city, we get knowledge, but also inspiration, and then we project it out to our work again, digest almost things that we see, and we respond to emotionally but also logically, and we try to process it into the design process, and then hopefully it's placed back into the city or as a material for thought, and not really as a final prototype but as a discussion element. The discussion is part of the, as we see it, is really something to be discussed here, because it's something so local that for outsiders it will be very hard to understand, I think, the small resolutions of the project.